Welcome to my College Basketball Arena series, where I recap each venue I attend throughout the season. Before I cover the Dunn Center, here's a brief background on Austin Peay. Austin Peay was founded in 1927 at the unoccupied site of Southwestern Presbyterian, which had relocated to Memphis and is today Rhodes College. It's the same site of a former Civil War military hospital. Austin Peay opened in 1929. It was named after Governor Austin Peay, a Clarksville resident who signed a law establishing the school but died while governor in 1927. Many buildings on campus are named after former governors. The school saw 52% enrollment growth from 2001 to 2010, making it Tennessee's fastest growing university in the 2000s. As of 2017, the school is now governed by its own board of trustees. Previously, it had been governed by the State of Tennessee Board of Regents. Austin Peay is located in Clarksville, Tennessee, 45 minutes northwest of Nashville, near the Kentucky state line. Clarksville has had a booming population from 22,000 in 1960 to 166,000 in 2020. And here's a graph demonstrating the exponential population growth of Clarksville and the Clarksville metropolitan area over the past 50 years. The Austin Peay governors have been members of the Mississippi Valley Conference, the Tennessee Intercollegiate Athletic Conference, the Volunteer State Athletic Conference, the Ohio Valley Conference, and soon to be the ASUN.
Down in the southeast, tiny Austin Peay State University was a long shot against Illinois. But when the game of the day was over, the pride of Clarksville, Tennessee, waltzed away with a major opening round upset.
Governor's basketball had an undefeated 19-0 team in 1939-40. They moved up from college division to university division in 63, the same year they moved from the Volunteer State Athletic Conference to the OVC. The Governors have 7 NCAA tournament appearances. They went to the Sweet 16 in 73, losing to Kentucky in overtime. They scored an upset over Illinois in 87, making it the third 14-3 upset of all time. Dick Vitale said he would stand on his head if the Governors won and traveled to Austin Peay to follow through on his promise. One of Austin Peay's most iconic players is Fly Williams. He was recruited to Austin Peay in 71 by Leonard Hamilton over 50 years ago. He played for the Governors from 72 through 74. He was welcomed to campus by a skywriter that spelled out Fly's name. He was top 5 scoring nationally both years he played and led Austin Peay to the Sweet 16 his first year, losing to Kentucky in overtime, and then the NCAA tournament his second year. Fly's number 35 was retired by Austin Peay in 2009, and a common chant back then was, "The Fly is open, let's go Peay." Originally, Austin Peay's athletic teams were nicknamed the Normalites or the Warriors, and then in 1937, they adopted the Governors as a tribute to Governor Austin Peay. There was a 2015 election over who would be the governor between Governor PX and the Gov. Governor PX won the election with over 64% of the votes between 2,500 votes cast. The school announced that Governor PX, who had been the mascot since 2002, would be the athletics-focused traditional mascot who is atop the hierarchy. They then named the Gov Lieutenant Governor. He would be the community-focused mascot who's shorter, more hunchback, and visits schools. However, in the game I went to, the mascot looked an awfully lot more like the Gov. As you can see in the bottom picture, he looks a lot more like the mascot to the left on the top picture. So I'm not sure what the mascot situation is now, as I couldn't find anything in my research. Austin Peay has a big rivalry with Murray State. They're 65 miles apart. They've had 139 all-time meetings, 132 since 1964. This rivalry, the Battle of the Border, was featured by ESPN the magazine. It also sent a Dunn Center attendance record with 8,911 in January of 77. Peay fans would often chant, "Let's go Peay," while Murray fans would often retort, "Flush the Peay." Before the Dunn Center, there was the Memorial Gymnasium, otherwise known as the Little Red Barn. Memorial Gymnasium was the governor's home court from 52 through 75. Before 52, they had played in the Armory. The Little Red Barn has had paranormal reports of the sound of hooves from a ghost mule. The school had enrolled a large number of GIs in the 1940s, and an old gentle mule gave rides to children across campus. When that mule passed away, it was buried in the field where a memorial gymnasium would be built. And it's ironic that it's a ghost mule considering their rival is the Murray State Racers. Memorial Gymnasium had 3,000 seats crammed close to the floor. Peay Mania back then, especially in the Fly Williams era, was a term for the enthusiasm by Austin Peay fans. And there was so much demand for tickets in the Fly Williams era that it forced the issue to build a new arena. And in the final year of Memorial Gymnasium, before the Dunn Center, although this was now after Fly Williams, 1,400 of the rollaway bleachers slated for the upper deck at the Dunn Center were temporarily installed at Memorial Gym to meet the demand for tickets. Construction started at the Dunn Center, also known as the house that Fly built, in February 73 with a December 1, 74 deadline. It was not completed until June of 75. It had a planned 9,000 seats. There was a debate over whether to move games into the Dunn Center during the 74-75 season before the building was ready, as only 6,000 seats were ready, since 1,400 of the rollaway bleachers slated for the upper deck of the Dunn Center were ordered a year early and installed in Memorial Gymnasium to help alleviate the seating crisis there. It was estimated that it would take a month to take them all apart at Memorial Gymnasium and install them into the Dunn Center. So the decision was made to play out the rest of the season at Memorial Gymnasium. The Dunn Center was built for a $5.3 million construction cost, and it was 78 feet from the top of the building down to the court. The first game at the house that Fly built was on December 1, 1975 versus Old Dominion. The Dunn Center's inaugural game drew 7,000 attendants. The image on the right shows the original seating plan and the revised seating plan with student seating shaded. The original seating plan had students taking one side from the floor-level rollaway bleachers, of which there would have been about 700 allotted for student seats, to the upper-level theater seats, while season ticket holders would take the other side. The athletic department scrapped the original seating plan and went with the revised seating plan, where the students would take the entire floor-level rollaway bleachers, while season ticket holders would take the upper-level theater seats. When the Dunn Center opened in 75, season tickets were $27 for the second-level theater seats, while general admission was $3 for a second-level theater seat and then $2 to sit on the third level. The Dunn Center's full name was the Winfield Dunn Health and Physical Education Building and Convocation Complex, named after Governor Winfield Dunn, who's still kicking it today at about 95 years old. The Dunn Center's attendance record was set in January of 77 versus Murray State with 8,911. The Governors have an all-time 69% winning percentage at the Dunn Center with four undefeated home seasons. That included a 29-game home winning streak from 2002 through 2004 under Dave Luce. Capacity was eventually lowered from 9,000 to 7,257. A 2004 renovation took the court-level bleachers and replaced them with cushioned telescopic seating. A 2007 renovation took the second-level chairbacks and replaced them with cushioned stadium seats. In January of 88, the basketball arena was named Dave Aaron Arena. Dave Aaron was an athletic director, basketball coach, football coach, and coach of other sports, and he was the only inductee of Austin Peay's inaugural Hall of Fame class in 77. The court was named Dave Luce Court in 2007. Dave Luce was an athletic director and basketball coach. He's the winningest coach in OVC history with 420 wins. He was a five-time OVC champion, four-time coach of the year, and went to four NCAA tournaments. Here's a graph showing Austin Peay's year-by-year per-game attendance, starting with the first year the NCAA started keeping track, 77-78, all the way through 2020. As you can see, after the 87 upset of Illinois, there was a huge spike for a couple years. Greg Walker was the Governor's legendary announcer from 82 through 2016. His 2001 OVC championship call in a loss to Eastern Illinois was named the best call in the history of sports by Mike and Mike. Greg Walker hosted the country's longest-running local sports talk show for 38 years, and he was known for stealing the show with his dance moves. All four sides of the Dunn Center have a sea of banners. On one side, you have the retired numbers and the legends. On the other sideline, you have all the NCAA banners for all the sports. And on the two ends, you have a lot of conference championship banners. Here is a glimpse of the trophy case in the lobby of the Dunn Center. There are displays for Governor Legends, and then there's a few OVC trophies in there. You can see the old school OVC logo on that one trophy. One thing that will catch your attention in the Dunn Center is the sheer amount of shelter area signs. In that photo in the top left, you can count 5 shelter area signs alone. Austin Peay has a history with severe weather. The 1999 Clarksville tornado was an F3 tornado that ripped through campus and severely damaged historic buildings and shattered 130 trees. There was $17 million in damages on campus and marked the largest property loss in state history. In the 2018 Battle of the Border game versus Murray State, a lightning strike blew a hole in the roof. Both athletic directors were on the catwalk, nearly 78 feet high, inspecting the roof. The game was delayed 3 hours as fans took shelter during a tornado warning, and a tornado actually touched ground in Clarksville that night. The game would then resume at 11:30 as the Racers clinched the OVC title. I've only been to Clarksville a couple times, but some of the things I liked were the Fort Defiance Civil War Park, Fort Campbell over the border in Kentucky, and the 3D indoor miniature golf, which also had a laser maze. Austin Peay will be moving into downtown Clarksville in the F&M Bank Arena, which opens in 2022, has a 5,500 capacity and $115 million construction cost. The next minute will be the final seating ever at the Dunn Center of All Hail to Austin Peay. In the final 5 minutes will be a photo slideshow of the Dunn Center.